Welcome back to another helpful chapter of our Endzone Survival Guide. Today's topic is all about electricity. Let's begin this lesson with the introduction of our specially designed solar collector. This marvel of technology produces a specified amount of solar energy to power buildings connected to the network. It's beautiful, isn't it? And the easiest way to distribute power within our settlement are power lines, wooden poles that connect the solar collector with appropriate buildings, resulting in one big electrical grid. But you've got to be careful when extending the electrical grid. If the connected buildings consume too much power, the electrical grid is at risk of overloading. In case of emergency, you have to act fast and decommission expendable buildings. Therefore, always keep an eye on your overall power consumption. The main benefit of buildings connected to the electrical grid is that their working efficiency gets a significant boost on both day and nighttime. Oh, one thing I forgot to mention about solar collectors. They only generate electricity when the sun is up, which can be quite troublesome every now and then. No need to panic though. Of course, we have a solution for this as well. The battery. A battery allows us to store excess energy during daytime, feeding it back into the network at night to secure a steady power supply for all of us. With the excess power of our batteries, we're able to burn the candle at both ends. To see our settlement ablaze with light, even at night, lifts the mood and has a favorable effect on our people's mind. A glimmer of hope in an otherwise grim world. And that's it for today. I'll see you next time when it says again, Endzone, a World Apart Survival Guide. Stay safe, everyone.